Are you interested in growing malting barley? Watch this video to understand some key grain quality requirements for making malt. Hi, I'm Christy Borelli, an extension educator in agronomy with Penn State. Malting barley has specific characteristics and must meet strict criteria for it to be developed into a high-quality malt. Malting barley grain is purchased by malt houses that process it into malt prior to brewing. It is important to consult with a malt house or a grain buyer before you plant. Shown here are some malt houses in Pennsylvania. Grain may also be purchased by larger grain companies that then sell to malt houses. Contact a buyer early so you know exactly which varieties and quantities they are accepting. Malting is a process in which grain is steeped in water and partially germinated before it is dried and stabilized. Malt provides color and flavor compounds for beer. It also provides the starch and enzymes necessary to produce fermentable sugars. For malting to occur, barley must have optimal germination potential, protein content, moisture content, and kernel consistency. It must also be free of mycotoxins. If these factors do not meet the desired ranges, grain cannot be used for malting and will likely be rejected by the malt house. Let's look at the specific requirements for each factor in more detail. Barley must be alive in order to be processed into malt. Germination determines how much of the grain will be activated in the malting process and how long the grain can be stored and still be viable for malting over time. For example, this photo shows grain germinating in the first stages of malt making. Quality seeds should have a germination rate of 95% or higher. Barley's germination energy is measured using rapid viscoanalysis, or RVA. An RVA above 120 is ideal as it indicates sound grain quality and its ability to retain that quality in storage. An RVA below 50 indicates severe pre-harvest germination. This crop has poor quality and storage ability and will be rejected for sales for malting. Intermediate RVA values between 50 and 120 are somewhat lower in quality, but will still likely be accepted by the malt house if other quality factors are also acceptable. Grain protein at harvest is also extremely important, since it affects the starch and enzyme levels needed for malting. Grain protein content must be between 9.5 and 12.5% of dry weight. If the protein content is too high, less malt extract will be available to the brewer, and it is more difficult to modify at the malt house. When the protein content is too low, enzymatic activity may be insufficient to break down the starch during brewing. Grain moisture content is another important quality factor to consider since it can impact storage as well as germination values. Low moisture content helps retain quality during storage, reduces the risk of mold, and increases the ability to preserve germination potential. It is recommended that the moisture content be below 13.5% when the grain goes into storage. If the grain is too wet in the field, you can dry it at temperatures below 100 degrees Fahrenheit, but it's important not to damage the grain's germination potential with high heat. Kernel consistency is another important quality factor. Plump, uniform kernels produce a good, evenly germinating malt and maximize the extract potential from the grain. Fortunately, malting barley varieties are bred specifically to promote good malting and brewing performance, but they can all behave differently during the malting process. This is why it is important to use a high-quality seed and not to mix grains with different varieties or quality factors. Penn State researchers host malting barley variety trials in southeast and central Pennsylvania each year to determine how location influences the different crops. Finally, we must consider crop diseases that can cause high levels of mycotoxins and reduce grain quality. Quality factors associated with crop diseases, particularly Fusarium head blight, can be substantial in the northeast warm, wet climate. This is what Fusarium head blight looks like. Fusarium can cause high levels of the mycotoxin, deoxynivalenol, or DON, that can affect food quality and make people sick. DON levels must be at or below 1 part per million for malting barley to be acceptable for human consumption. Now let's review the quality factors to consider when growing malting barley. Germination should be 95% or higher, with an RVA at or above 120. Protein content should be between 9.5 and 12%. The moisture content should be under 13.5% with good kernel consistency. And low mycotoxins, where DON levels are no greater than 1 part per million. Due to the extreme importance of grain quality, malting barley producers are encouraged to focus more on achieving grain quality factors and less on getting high yields. A high-yielding crop with low quality isn't worth much at a malt house, but high-quality grains are in high demand and allow malt houses to craft quality products. And finally, it is recommended that you contact a malt house or a grain buyer before planting. They can provide additional guidance about their preferred varieties and the quantities needed. For more specific and up-to-date information about each of the varieties, go to the Penn State Extension's website, extension.psu.edu, and search for barley and wheat performance trials.